Good evening, my fellow South Africans. I have recently seen the Springboks and true leadership, and I have therefore decided, as Cyril Ramaphosa, that I will be stepping down as president of South Africa with immediate effect. Thank you very much. God bless South Africa. Nkosi sikelele Africa. Malupakanisu pondolwayo. Izwa imitanda zoyetu. Nkosi sikelela tina lusapolwayo. Nkosi. How's everybody? Hope you guys are all doing all right. Thank you so much for tuning in. Welcome to a special edition live stream where the president will be wasting our time later. It doesn't start right now. It's going to start at 8 p.m. This is a stream for me and the people that usually watch my show. And then at 8 p.m. we'll be switching over, listening to what the president has to say. I'm suspecting that the ANC is going to try and steal the Springboks' glory, because the ANC has stolen everything else. You know, considering that the ANC has stolen electricity, stolen our dignity, stolen everything, the only thing left to steal is other people's glory. Literally. So they want to steal other people's achievements. So my prediction is that Cyril Ramaphosa is going to come on, say, oh, the Springboks did such an amazing job, and this is because of the funding that we have put into youth development and sport development, and, you know, the Springboks, under my leadership as the president, have won 2 World Cups. I'm the only president that have seen them win 2 World Cups, therefore I'm better than Jacob Zuma, and I'm better than Thabo Mbeki. So you must vote for me for a third term, please. So yeah. Anyway, welcome everybody. Be sure to smash that like button. Be sure to subscribe if you are not subscribed. It'll be greatly appreciated. Welcome to all the members. Welcome to all the viewers. Welcome to all the subscribers. First and foremost, congratulations to the Springboks for winning an amazing World Cup final. I don't think anybody in South Africa can say that it was boring. It might not have been the most attractive rugby match ever played, or beautiful match ever played, but strategically, it was phenomenal. Remember that Bongi is not our first choice for hooker. Marx is. So Dion Fourie was the third line of defense. So Marx was taken out, Bongi was taken out. Well, when I say taken out, let's just call it a fair tackle that was given a yellow card, right? Anyway, so Dion Fourie was our third choice hooker. So they, from the very start, managed to annihilate the supremacy up front that we had. Not that Dion Fourie is not like a great player, but Dion Fourie is obviously not Marx. He's not Bongi. He's not a hooker. That sounds very weird. Dion Fourie is not a hooker. He's not a hooker. Okay? Dion Fourie, I think versus Romania was the first time that he played a test match for his country as a hooker. That was the first time he played in that position. So, yeah, I mean, it was phenomenal. And to get the All Blacks to not score a single point for the last 24 minutes of the game is insane. We all know that New Zealand is that side that in the last 5 minutes they score points. For 24 minutes, they didn't score. The last 24 minutes, they didn't score a point. I don't think people truly appreciate what the Springboks managed to achieve. People go, we won the World Cup. People go, oh, you know, we won by a point. But it's like, I would say that this South African side reflects South Africa more than any other side previously. Because we had to work for every single thing. Like, and then we almost lost it, but then we managed to just get over the finish line, which is what South Africans are currently doing in this country. And I am going to politicize it. I am. Of course I'm going to politicize it. Like, South Africa at the moment, we load shedding is bringing us down. The ANC is stealing from us. You know, the country is junk status. There's so many things wrong in this country, but South Africans just continue to thrive. South Africans just continue to beat the odds. And that is exactly what the Springboks did on Saturday. So if you guys shed a tear for Chasing the Sun, that documentary, this one is going to be next level. This documentary that Showmax hopefully produces in the next 2 days is going to be phenomenal. So I can't wait for Chasing the Croissant or whatever they're going to call it. I don't know. I can't wait for it. I can't wait for it. So well done to Jock Nienaber. Welcome to well done to Rassie Erasmus. Well done to Sia Kulisi. Well done to Ox, to the like Frans Malherbe, Pieter Steph de Toy, 28 donors at tackles. And every tackle was like, how do you put it? Pieter Steph de Toy tackled the demons out of every single person he tackled. 28 tackles. Faf de Klerk, just being on the field with that beautiful hair. That was enough. With that beautiful hair. That he deserved the World Cup trophy just for having that beautiful flowing locks. I mean, the entire team. The entire team. Brilliant. Well done. And then Andre Pollard scoring all the points and not missing a kick. Not missing a single kick in the World Cup. Well done. Well done. So what I'm trying to say is well done to the Springboks on arguably the best Rugby World Cup outcome, playing 5 of the top 6 teams. And they couldn't play the 6th one because it was them. They were one of the top 6. So when a New Zealander or an English person or an Irish person or a French person tells you that it's unattractive rugby, all you need is just, hey, when you look at that Webb Ellis trophy and you see there next to, what does it say there next to 2023? What say it though? Lungs 2023. What does it say? Hey? Because if I have to ask you now quickly, 1995, who did South Africa play against in that World Cup? Who did they play against? Quickly. Can you mention it? 2007, who did South Africa play against? Quickly. What was their best performing game? No, you don't remember. All you remember is when that final whistle blew and you hear, bring the mighty book. He call me Aussie. Pam 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 pam. You see, that's all you remember. That's all you should remember. So yeah, well done to the Springboks. And now we're gonna get Cyril Ramaphosa at 8 PM coming on and telling us. I was there for the final because I did not believe in the quarters. I did not want to fly to the quarterfinals or to the semis. But I'm here for the final because it took me 8 seconds. 8 seconds to latch onto that World Cup as soon as Sia Kulisi raised it. Think I'm joking. 8 seconds. I'm not going to play it because World Rugby will demonetize this video because that's how they are. It took Cyril Ramaphosa 8 seconds from when Sia Kulisi lifted the World Cup. 8 seconds for him to latch onto it. He couldn't even give the Springbok squad a minute to enjoy the trophy. Not even a minute. And somebody on Twitter posted something phenomenal, which is very, very true. They said, here's the difference between a true leader and a leader, in the sense of the intentions of a true leader. You see Cyril Ramaphosa in the front, latching onto the World Cup. And then if you look at the same photo from a different angle, you see Rassie Erasmus in the background, behind all the players, behind all of them, in the corner there, just looking and smiling. That's like the two type of leaders you get. The one that's in it for themselves and the one that's in it for the people and for the team. That's the difference. I can tell you now, if the Springboks, listen now, and I don't want you to lie. Be honest now. And this is somebody that's in a political party. If the Springboks had to create a political party as soon as they land, and the Springbok players will all be ministers, would you vote for them, yes or no? Would you vote for them, yes or no? If the Springboks landed and said, hey, listen, we have had enough of this cuck, we're going to start our own political party, Siya Kolisi will be the president, and Pieter Steef will be the minister of defense, would you vote for them, yes or no? You know you will. You know you will. Why? Because they infuse and show what South Africa is about. And you know their hearts are in the right places. Yo, there was one funny thing that I saw. Tefetsego Fiditswe. Ox. That's his real name. Am I getting it right? Tefetsego Fiditswe. Nche. Ox. You need to say his whole name. Refiditswe. No, man. Now I'm getting it right. Retsego Fiditswe Nche. It's a very long name. So excuse me if I don't get it right the first time. He what was that thing about the cake that he said that was hilarious? He said something along the lines of like, let me see if I'll tell you now exactly what he said. And it's like, it is just so iconic. It is absolutely iconic. Let me find it. Jared Wright tweeted it out. Jared Wright. It was hilarious. Sorry. By the way, the president will be addressing us at 8 p.m. It's going to be painful, but I'm suspecting he's going to give us a public holiday. How many of you are willing to take that bet? I'll donate 50 rand to charity if he does not give us a public holiday. He's going to give us a public holiday. Let me just find this quick. Where is it now? Yaramani man tweet buyer. I want that tweet from earlier. I'm just looking for it. But post in the comments along. Let me know. He's going to give us a public holiday. It's something that Ox said here. Okay. Come on. It's not taking a bit long. I'll check now what you guys have to say. Let me know in the comments if you think he's going to give us a public holiday. By the way, if you tuned in, welcome. Be sure to smash that like button. Be sure to subscribe. Consider becoming a member of this channel for more of this type of content. You're more than welcome to give a super chat if you want. I mean, you know, I am a politician. Apparently, I have to eat, you know. Like Mama Joy. Mama Joy is just eating nonstop. And don't worry. Don't worry. I'm getting to Mama Joy. Don't you worry. If you tuned in hoping that I was going to speak about Mama Joy, don't you worry. I'm definitely going to talk about Mama Joy. I just need to find this. Okay, let me just do this. Nche cake. That's all I need to do. Yes, there we go. Okay. So Ox Nche was asked what cake he is going to eat to celebrate last night. This is what he answered. I'm thinking caramel cheesecake. I saw it earlier at the hotel. So literally before they left the hotel to go and play in the World Cup, Ox eyed a little caramel cheesecake at the hotel that they were staying. Now in my head, I'm going, he's like, he was eyeing that thing going like, excuse me, I'll be back later. I've just got a little business to attend to, you know. I'll grab you later, my friend. So imagine, like, Ox walking out and checking, like, ooh, caramel cheesecake. Sounds delicious. I'll definitely grab that later. And, I mean, it's amazing. That is just the true spirit of South Africa. He's going to expropriate our next public holiday. That's probably true. Voter says, met matric examens. Well, that's going to be the interesting one. I mean, whenever has the ANC cared about education, to be honest? I mean, they don't really care about education. They'll probably move that pass rate down for that one day to like 3%. And then still a lot of people will fail. Debbie Murray, thank you so much for the super chat. It's greatly appreciated. What can I do here? I can even put you on a timeout on a super chat. Do you know that? I can put you on a timeout for a super chat. YouTube's got no chill there. Let me not accidentally do that. Debbie, thank you very much for the 140 Rand super chat. It's greatly appreciated, saying Friday is a public holiday with the World Cup. Yeah, I think Friday or Monday. I think Friday or Monday, or he's going to announce a day sometime in the future that's going to be a public holiday. But thank you very much for the super chat, Debbie. I agree. I appreciate it quite substantially. All right. Here's an interesting tidbit for you. And I'm going to talk about Mama Joy for like 3 or 4 minutes, right? So Mama Joy, do you know how many days Mama Joy spent in France? I'll tell you, 54 days. Mama Joy was in France for 54 days. 5,000 rand a night? I mean, we know that she did an Airbnb. We know that Mama Joy stayed at least at a 4 to 5 star hotel. So she spent 54 days in France. Before that, she attended 2 other World Cups, one overseas and one in Cape Town, right? First question, how many like leave days does Mama Joy have left? Because I'm assuming she does not have a job. Because if she has a job, that job is gone. Because 54 days in another country, like, and other World Cups, so is this her job? Is her full-time job leeching off of taxpayers? Is that her full-time job? It must be. Surely it must be. Her full-time job is leeching off of taxpayers. Johan van Skalkwijk, thank you for the 70 rand, saying, dankie vir alles, Renaldo. Dis net 'n plesier, chom. Dankie vir die super chat. Ek waardeer dit. Waardeer dit opreg. Mense sê ek is jaloers. They say I'm jealous of Mama Joy. I'm not sure exactly of what. I mean, I've traveled the world at my own expense. I definitely will feel too guilty to use taxpayers' money to go overseas. So definitely not jealous. But I just want an honest question. 54 days in France. And then one of her first tweets after being there on taxpayers' money, staying in 4 to 5 star hotels, not Airbnbs. One of her first tweets after that was, we got the cup. Can I go to India now? You know when die, in Afrikaans sê hulle genoeg is genoeg. Genoeg is genoeg, you know? You just had 54 days in France at a 4 or 5 star hotel. What is 5,000 rand times 54? Let me see. I need to work it out. Like 54 times 5,000 rand. 270,000 rand. 270,000 rand. You just had a 54-day paid-for holiday from taxpayers' money that on accommodation alone at least cost you that much money. Not flights, not the tickets to the World Cup. The final, of course, the cheapest ticket being 18,000 Rand for where she sat. Not the food, not the pocket money, none of that. None of that. And let's not even talk about the other two World Cups. Let's not talk about that. Let's not talk about the Netball World Cup in Cape Town. Let's not talk about, what was the other one? The FIFA Soccer World Cup in New Zealand. Is it right? New Zealand, Australia. Let's not talk about that. Let's not talk about that. And the first question you've got to ask is, can you now go to India? When is enough enough? That's the honest to God question I've got. Wanneer is genoeg genoeg? I don't know. Anyway, that was my 5 minutes speaking on Mama Joy. We'll be switching over to listen to the president take credit for the Springboks winning the World Cup at 8 p.m. And maybe we'll get a public holiday out of it. I'm not too sure. Mariki Jonker, who's been a member for 25 months, says, good evening, Ronaldo. Is it true that they're not coming to us with the Springbok Champion Tour? Yes, they're skipping Nelson Mandela Bay and they're going to East London. I mean, here's the thing, right? How do I put it? Well, let me put it bluntly. That's how I put things. So you're telling me, as SARU, right? As a South African rugby union, you are not bringing the Springboks to the place where the captain and the director of rugby and the one of the defense coaches or sticks, I'm not sure what his exact title is, but he's one of the coaches, right? So you're telling me that at least three of the people that's quite in senior positions in the Springboks, they're not coming to Nelson Mandela Bay. The captain, who's from Zwide in Port Elizabeth, Styx from Port Elizabeth, and Rassie Erasmus from Dispatch in Nelson Mandela Bay. You're telling me that you're not bringing them to do a tour. You're going to East London. Okay. Good luck with that. Good luck. Peter van der Merwe, welcome to the Voortrekkers. Welcome to the fun. Check in your Voortrekker pack. You'll get a link to a dedicated WhatsApp group for Voortrekkers. Welcome to the family. Can we get some hearts in the chat? Welcome to the 626 people that is tuned in. It's greatly appreciated. Thank you. Be sure to smash that like button and be sure to subscribe. Wolfie, thank you so much for the 14 Rand super chat. It's greatly appreciated. Thank you, Wolfie. Voter says, vakantiedag 27 December 2023. Minste disruptions, sê maar net. I think most people are on holiday. And isn't the, I don't even know. I don't even know if the 27th is a public holiday or not. I understand that there are still some people working. But yeah. I don't know. How would you pronounce the name Jurgens? That's how I would pronounce it. It's Jurgens. Not Jurgens. Ek is Afrikaans, so for me is it makkelijk. Jurgens. Am I right, Leslie? Is that the right way to say it? Jurgens. Yeah. Jurgens said it. By the way, we will be switching over at 8 p.m., which is 30 minutes from now. So if you want to go and watch a still stream on SABC or on Eyewitness News or whomever, you can. Otherwise, you can stay here and have some fun while we talk about some stuff happening in South Africa. Christopher says, I wear an Aldo. How's it? Robin says, public holiday in December, maybe. It could be. I think that you'll probably make it sooner rather than later. Yaku says, bet you 100 rand hy gaan laat wees. I can guarantee you he's going to be late. He's not going to be on time. That's for sure. Daar sal een wees op die 25ste. Nice. Yo, Andries P just literally paid off my mortgage with that 12 euro donation. Thank you very much. Thank you so much for the 12 euros. Our currency has gone down the shitter, so that 12 euros is definitely going to pay my home off. Thank you very much. I want to do a plug here, and I'm not getting paid, but I appreciate people that come up with an amazing original concept, right? So to the 600 people watching, right? Thank you very much for tuning in. It's greatly appreciated. And I want you to do me a favor and check this board game out, right? So this board game is called Steal and Plunder, right? And sorry for the white little marks. It's Carter's Gop that's on you, right? The game is called Steal and Plunder, and it is definitely a very original South African game, right? So in the bag, which looks like, you know, a money bag that you've stolen, it's called Steal and Plunder. Can one of my moderators just put the link in the description, please? The game is called Steal and Plunder. Be sure to check it out. So what you get in here is you obviously get the board game, Steal and Plunder. It says there, under corruption, first edition. 3 to 6 players, 13s and above. It takes 20 minutes. Master the art of corruption, steal and plunder your way to the top of Mzansi's shadow economy. And then obviously it shows you, like, it pretty much teaches you what the plot of the game is. It's very cool. I'm not going to explain it here because it's too long. You can just go and check out the YouTube videos. But what they sent me was quite hilarious. Did somebody post the link yet? I want to just share what they sent you, and so that you can get an idea of what the game is about, right? So like I said, the game is called Steal and Plunder. You can check out how to play the game. There's YouTube videos available. So the first thing is copper, because, you know, copper theft. And then it says there, wealth card, stolen copper wire, 50,000 rand. Here we go. You see, there's one of the benefits of the game right here. And then a box of cigarettes. But guess what? It is illegal cigarettes. Yes, it's counterfeit cigarettes. Ask the EFF. They will know all about it. And that is worth 50,000 rand. Oh, and you like that very nice perfume? Guess what? It's counterfeit perfume. It's fake. Fake perfume. 100,000 rand. Booyah. Gold series. London, New York, Paris. Right? What else is there? Well, we all need bribe money. Can I interest you? Can I interest you in a 10,000 key over there, huh? Can I interest you there? You see, what does it say there? Sorry, doesn't zoom in. Bribe money. Cater deployment. Mama Joy. Yeah, Mama Joy. Here's money for you for your trip to India, Mama Joy. Enjoy it. Spend it wisely. And then, of course, some benefits. Some liberated livestock. Nah, seriously, well done. Well done. Please check out the game. Steal and Plunder. Check it out. Thank you, everyone, for posting the link. It's emceegames.co.za. So it's MC, but it's EMCEE. Oh, God. emceegames.co.za. Be sure to go and check it out. Steal and Plunder. Support local. Support the guys that come up with these amazing initiatives. Steal and Plunder. Check out the website. Check them on social media. And do the right thing and buy the board game. It's quite cool. Not getting paid a cent. Just love to support local, as you guys know. So support local. And, you know, maybe you can also benefit from some copper theft. This is my favorite, by the way. To the makers of the game, MCs, this is brilliant. I wonder if this is worth, if I had to take this now and get some copper money, I wonder. It's definitely copper. Definitely. Yeah. Did you guys, like, wonder if the guys making the game, if they actually just went to, like, a illegal scrapyard and bought some cop? I'm joking. No, they would not have. All right. The president will be addressing us, speaking about corruption. The president will be speaking at 8 p.m., which is 26 minutes from now. He is going to be late. Wat het gebeur met boerkola? Boerkola is in most shops. Boerkola has exploded. There's boerbier, boerkola. There's a boer restaurant. Don't remember what the name is now. What is the restaurant? Boerkombees or something like that. Anyway, thank you for the 14 rand, Jurgens. It's greatly appreciated. Jurgens Stemmet. Is your pa Johan Stemmet by any chance? Fred B. Kevin gave a 40 rand super sticker. Thank you very much, Fred B. Kevin. I really appreciate it. Wolfie said, love you, bro. Been watching since 2016. Thank you. That's quite a long time. It's almost, it's 8 years. Well, almost 8 years. Leon, known as Leo 2000, gave a 35 rand super chat saying, Ronaldo, of course you aren't getting paid for the plug. You either stole the game and the payment or they bribed you. Cater deployment. Exactly. Now you start seeing how this game works. It's a very cool game. It's a very cool game. Be sure to check it out. Okay, let me get to some questions here. Okay, I'm not reading Darren's comment there. When does Sia leave the Springboks? I don't know, but he's going to be 37 in 2027 for the next World Cup. I don't know. Do you think that's too old? Or do you think that is... I don't know. Hey, 37 in his position, I think is like... I think it's a bit too old. Maybe because he'll be the captain, maybe. Even though he might not be in his prime, he'll play like 30 minutes and then go off. I don't know. I hope that he goes for a third World Cup. That'll be amazing. But I don't really think that he'll be like fit enough at that age for that position, if that makes sense. Devin says, the president talking reminds me of lockdown. I know, I get like very negative vibes whenever whenever they announce the president will be addressing it. I'm like, what lockdown level are we going to be now? What lockdown level? He has another World Cup in him, but not as captain. Oof, that's going to be a tough one though, hey, because... Unless he says that he doesn't want to be the captain, which I know that he'll probably do, but I don't know if people will accept that, hey? I mean, the people love Siya Kolisi, and rightfully so. Rightfully so. He has been phenomenal. He's been absolutely phenomenal. Have you watched Gran Turismo, the movie? Yes. It was one of those popcorn movies, but it was really good. If I can recommend a show for all of you to watch, and once again, it's not paid for. Whenever there's this many viewers, I have to say that it's not paid for, right? The Fall of the House of Usher. Brilliant. The Fall of the House of Usher. Phenomenal. Phenomenal. Check it out. It's on Netflix. Really, really good. What have I missed here? Candace says, I've got PTSD from the president talking. First thing I said is no lockdown. Yeah, it's not going to be a lockdown. It's going to be something as painful. It's him talking about successes that they've had nothing to do with. The Springboks won the World Cup despite everything that the ANC has done in this country, not because of what the ANC has done. That I can guarantee you. And nothing actually shows this as much as, and once again, I'm going to mention Mama Joy, but the Department of Sport does not have money to send athletes overseas to represent South Africa, but they've got enough money to pay for Mama Joy and Boeta and their crew to take photos and selfies for 54 days in France. They've got money for that, but they don't have money for this young up-and-coming athlete that might not be in a mainstream sport, but it's still in something that we'll claim a victory for if they end up winning gold, you know? That's always a good, like, oh, why should we support these guys fighting in judo or karate? Because if they win a gold medal at the Olympics, then everybody's going to talk about them and claim their victories. That's what they're going to do. So, yes, sending an athlete, irrespective of whatever sport they compete in, if they've got talent and ability and they can be the best in the world, or at least rank up there, then you need to support them. Because with all due respect, which means no respect, anybody can dress up the way Mama Joy dresses up with a South African banner or with a SARP and stand there and look at the camera and go, anybody can do that. You don't need to be a specialist athlete to stand there in your gear. Anybody can dress you up like that and with the South Africa doing that. I mean, there were actually thousands of South Africans that were at the World Cup, not on the taxpayers' dime, that did that. So when you want to talk about like these, you want to defend these athletes, you want to defend these super fans over athletes that can't get funding, you can sack. Seriously. Because anybody can dress up in a South African flag or wear traditional Xhosa or Afrikaner or Zulu attire and stand there with a sarepiki that says South Africa on it and get airtime on the TV, right? So many of them did, in actual fact. Those ladies with the traditional Xhosa hats, they got exposure, more airtime than Mama Joy, and they didn't cost the taxpayer a cent. Anyway, was a new education bill really passed? The Bella Bill? I believe so. I believe that it was passed. Because, you know, why would the ANC do the right thing, right? They just find ways to waste money just because they feel like it. I mean, it's ridiculous. We literally have athletes, and I know this because I get the emails. I get the emails from the parents and from the athletes themselves that ask if I, as the ward counselor, can donate money to them for their children to go overseas to represent South Africa. I get those emails. So it's not me thumb-sucking. It's me literally getting these emails where the Department of Sport is failing athletes, and then for some or other reason they can spend millions on super fans, but they can't spend millions on actual athletes. But hey, I'm the arsehole. I'm jealous. I'm jelly. It's me. I'm the problem. I'm a racist. It's me. Even though I suggested that for the Rugby World Cup, why don't you send just for argument's sake, not that it has to be about race, but why don't you send somebody that is a young rugby player from Sweden, where Siya Kolisi is from, right? Why don't you send a 16, 17 or 18 year old up-and-coming rugby player that is from the same place as the captain? Why don't you send that person and then dress them up with the South African banner and let them stand there? Why does it need to be this individual that is known in the soccer world? Because I bet you if you had to ask her, please quickly name 7 rugby players for me and tell me what you thought about the latest throw-in and how that affected the game. If you had to ask her, what is your opinion on that? I, Renaldo Gouws, believe that she would not have a clue. She would not have a clue. Please quickly tell me who's the 5 rugby players that's on the field right now, name number 1 to 5 for the South African side. Please quickly name them for me. Anyway, I'm ranting again. But I have to get it out of my system. John says, if you noticed, Mama Joy was largely ignored by the players when she tried to get their attention. Because they know. They know. Anyway, Gerard Scherber, thank you for the 35 Rand super chat saying, Ronaldo, play Ramaphosa video on member WhatsApp group. Just shared now. I don't have it open and I don't want to mess with... What did you send? Because... it logged me out, and I don't like playing stuff that I haven't checked. I don't like playing stuff. By the way, the president will be addressing us in 15 minutes. Sorry, I'm treating this like the tech chat because I didn't do a stream last night, but I will be switching over when the president goes live. I don't like to play these videos without seeing it. Not that I don't trust you, Gerardus, but I don't like playing videos. I mean, I've seen some shocking WhatsApps.
Oh. Okay.
Nah. I can't play that. No. Freelance says, did you hear about Matthew Perry died, the man from Friends? Yes, I know Matthew Perry. What was his name in Friends? Chandler. Yeah, rest in peace, Matthew Perry. That's crazy, though. He passed away from drowning. He drowned. That's crazy. That is one of my fears. Burning to death and drowning. It's my two biggest fears. Like, I want to go where... I want to go in the way where you're like, it's like something happens. You're like, how the hell did I survive that? That is how I want to go. Like, I want to go in the way where you, doya donor who tak dit oorleef, but you're actually dead. That is how I need to go. That's how I want to go. I don't want to go like 3 maande later. Awesome, yeah, or burning. I wanna go quick. Shark attack is a big fear. Well, CZS, the problem is that it's not really a fear because you just don't have to go to the ocean. You know, I mean, it's not like you're gonna wake up in one night and there's a shark next to you and it's gonna hit you. You know, like just don't go close to the ocean. Simple. Sorry, I'm just being silly now. Leanne says, Ronaldo, it is so amazing being the only country to have won the World Cup 4 times. True. And here's a even better statistic for you. So South Africa has won more World Cups than any other country, and it has played 2 less World Cups than New Zealand, England, Australia. Remember, South Africa didn't play in 1987 and 1991. So, statistically, above us winning the World Cup 4 times, the statistics is even better when you consider those two facts, that we missed 2 World Cups from when it started, and we still have won 4 more than any other nation. Suck on that, New Zealand. I can't be rude. I really, like, some New Zealand supporters are terrible, but the team itself is always so, like, respectful. And you have to respect the rivalry. Like, the All Blacks in South Africa. Like, that is, when you think about rugby, you have to admit, there's only one rivalry. The All Blacks versus the Springboks. That's it. They can, that whole England and France or Australia and New Zealand or Ireland and there's only one rivalry in rugby. One true rivalry. And that is the Springboks and the All Blacks. That's it. Right. Anyway, welcome to the 900 people that's watching. We will be switching over in 10 minutes when the president goes live. Whether he is going live in 10 minutes, I don't know, but I will be switching over as soon as he goes live. I can guarantee you that the president will be late. And I can guarantee you that the president is going to take credit for the Springboks winning the World Cup, even though him and his political party had absolutely nothing to do with that victory. Nothing. Nux. Dololo. But he's going to take credit for it. I suspect, though, I'm sorry, like, hierdie haartjies staan 'n bietjie uit hier so. Ek weet nie wat aangaan nie. I do suspect, though, that he will give us a public holiday. Leanne says, also, we have never lost when we were in the final. Another stat for you, up until that illegal try, that wasn't actually a try, that it was a knock-on, you know, that, let me see here. Let me see if I, like, I swear, if World Rugby takes me on this, if World Rugby takes me on this one, well, let me do this. Yeah. So I'm not going to play the video. I'm going to slow mode for you. So, okay. Blah, blah, blah. There, watch here. So watch here now. You ready for this? This is the only try that has ever been scored against South Africa in a final. Now, please tell me. Please tell me what you see right here. Whenever it decides to play. Is it going to play? Okay. She's what gaan aan? She's a bit scrum. Okay, let me do this. Yeah, watch it now. Watch what happens here. Where does that ball go? Yeah. Watch here. You see where the ball is now? You see where the body is? Look at where the ball bounces. Bunk. So that's where the ball bounces. This is where it released. Nia's backwards. It's backwards. Hierdie video is at a 45 degree angle and die bal beweeg op. Wat sê dit vir jou? It's forward. It's forward. This is the try that was allowed, by the way. This is the 5 points they got. So when they cry about, like, we lost with a point. No, technically you lost with 6. Daar sê, watch out. Punk. En dan gaat hy, ek het die 3 gedruk. And then, yeah. Check out. Punk. I don't fall forward into man. I don't care what you have to say. That's forward. That's not a try. Watch there. Punk. Knock on. Forward. Choose. Choose which one. Just does enough. Hey. Money party. Money. I was kind of. No. Money party. World Rugby is going to delete this channel. Anyway, welcome to the 1,000 people watching. Oh, we hit the 1,000 mark. Welcome. You found this channel. Be sure to subscribe. Be sure to smash the like button. So let's technically see. A quarter of you have smashed the like button. So can we make it 500? Can half of you smash the like button? Let's see. Smash the like button right now. And while you're at it, subscribe. And then after that, use your parents' credit card. Use all the way to the right and give a 15,000 rand super chat. I'm joking. Don't do that. Do not do that. No refunds. No refunds. Leslie gave a 10 euro super chat. Buy a donkey for Diane. Thank you. Says, got the name right. South Africa has a troubled and complicated past. Despite that, what unites South Africans and what should all South Africans be proud of? What unites us as a nation is, and this is going to sound weird, right? So obviously sport unites us. Specifically the Springboks, because of the significance with Nelson Mandela and Francois Pienaar, and it being the first World Cup when we became a democracy. So rugby has a very unique place in our hearts, right? And obviously your extremists like the EFF will say, oh, it's fake unity and this and that. The majority of South Africans know it's not. The majority of South Africans know exactly what it is. Here's the other thing. Our pain and suffering is what unites us as a nation. So indirectly, the ANC is also uniting this country. The EFF is trying to split us apart. But the ANC, as the government of this country, is uniting South Africans because we are all experiencing terrible service delivery. We are suffering under the ANC. So we are united. We get united by sports and we get united by suffering. Load shedding, as an example, brings us closer. Because I don't know anybody that likes load shedding. So when we get load shedded, everybody goes, fuck yo, I ain't see ya. Because we know. We know who is producing the lack of energy. That's weird. We know who's causing load shedding. Anyway, 6 minutes to go before the president addresses us. Thank you for that super chat. 10 euros. You just paid off my mortgage, Leslie. Thank you very much. Danny Doritos gave a $2 saying, kom ons gaan bokke if you're New Zealand. Okay, I think, Danny, I think you had nog a bubble last, dude. The game is klaar gespeel. Ons het hom gewen. Sorry to break it to you. We won the game. Because Danny is, kom ons gaan bokke if you New Zealand. Dink jy's 'n bietjie laat, ou chom. Of jy weet nie wat gebeur het nie. Spoiler alert. The Springboks won. Wolfie gave a 14 rand super chat saying, koop vir jou hond 'n vleisie en F die ANC man. O, koop vir jou hond 'n vleisie en F die ANC. Baie dankie. Baie dankie. I'm not sure if you noticed, but I'm trying to be more like less sweary. Less sweary. Want ek, some, I've had interactions with people where they go, oh, I love your content. My yes, jy raai een keer so gevloek toe my kinders na jou gekyk het. And ek says, oof. Because I mean, if I knew that everybody here was like adults, I would like, you know, the way that I feel about swear words is different to most people. Because a swear word, like a perfect example of this is kies 'n kant, you know. If I was in the UK and I said kant, dan gaan mense hulle minds verloor. But in South Africa, if you speak Afrikaans to somebody, ja man, kies 'n kant. You know, it's like, it's a word. You give it power. You give the word power. That's it. If somebody calls you the P word, if it offends you, like it's like being called a racist. Oh, I don't agree with your opinion. You know, you don't like Mama Joy spending taxpayers' money. You must be a racist. No, in actual fact, I want an underprivileged child that actually plays the sport to benefit. Not Mama Joy. The actual child, the underprivileged child, which more than likely will be colored or black. I want that child to benefit. But I'm a racist. You see, that's exactly the same way. It's the same mentality. The easy argument is, oh, I can't argue with you. I'm going to just call you a racist. That's the easiest thing. By the way, 3 likes away from 500. 3 likes away from 500. Make it happen. Make it happen. Laat ek het my oorietjies gou hier insit. Anyway, the president is supposed to go live in 3 minutes. We all know better though. Kom nou. Ons almal weet beter. Let me just connect here. Ons almal weet beter dat dit nie gaan gebeur nie. There we go. Now I can hear myself. Matthew says, racist. Exactly. Oh, and just like that, 500 and... Yo, die mense, smash that like button. Okay, so everybody smash the like button. Everybody, be sure to subscribe. If you'd like to become a member of the Voortsakker family, which is that family there. Yeah, verkeerde kant. There's a WhatsApp group called the Voortsakkers. The people that are that are members to this channel are called Voortsakkers. As you can see there, Voortsakkers. You can click the join button below and it'll cost you a minimal fee of, I think, one Big Mac a month. One Big Mac meal a month. And don't forget, I'm not going to do the whole spiel again. But if you like board games and you want to support local... And you want to get a game that is really a board game that's truly South African, check out Steal and Plunder. Just Google them. Steal and Plunder board game. I'm not even going to... Somebody will put the link over here, but check these guys out. Steal and Plunder. It's literally a board game where you need to be as corrupt as possible in order to win the game, which is very, very unique and suitable for South Africa. And then I've got some money here. Can I interest you in that buying that board game? You know, some sweetie geld. Sweetie geldies. Anyway, the president should be addressing us in 1 minute from now. But the SABC has not even gone live. There's nothing at the moment. So to whomever wanted to take that 100 rand deal, with me that he's going to be late. I'm not stupid. Ek is nie gister gebore nie. Welcome to the 1,663 people. You are appreciated. Thank you very much for being here. Smash the like button. Be sure to subscribe. And just quickly click on that super chat button and then max it all the way to the right. I think it's 7,500 rand. And if just 1% of you hit that, I can retire. No, I'm joking. Don't do it. If he is standing, aren't we in shit? Oh, no. He's going to, like, when they switch over to the president, he's going to be lying in his hotel room still. Okay, not really. But that would be hilarious. I mean, that would be a boss move. Imagine they go, we're switching over to the president, and he's like, my fellow South Africans, with some rose petals next to him. My fellow South Africans, I'm here to F you one last time. Oh, that'd be hilarious. He's going to wear a Springbok jersey. Can we say that? He will be wearing either... No, I'm going to double down. He's going to wear a Springbok jersey. I'm pretty sure he's going to wear... Like, he's not live yet. And he's late. The president is officially late. Surprise, surprise. He's going to announce a public holiday sometime in the near future. And he's going to take credit for the Springboks winning the World Cup. He's going to talk about... Do you guys think he's going to mention apartheid? Do you think, like, I mean, any time is probably the suitable time for the ANC to mention apartheid. But he's probably going to go back, you know, like, during the apartheid years, like, the Springboks are uniting us, considering they gaan ons nou terug. I don't think he'll go back as far as Jan van Riebeek, but I think he's going to go back. Yeah, apartheid. You know, we have transformed sport from when it was apartheid. Hy gaan terug. Jurgens, thank you for the 7 rand. Greatly appreciate it. Thank you for the super chat. Apartheid will feature. Okay, well, he's officially late. I'm suspecting that he's going to wear a Springbok jersey or something green and gold. Because, hey, you need to milk that, like, money. You need to milk that victory for all it's worth to claim that victory. By the way, welcome to the 2,300 people. We will be switching over as soon as the president goes live. But guess what? The president is late. Like always. At least... happy birthday, Muhammad. Can we all get some hearts in the chat for Muhammad, please? Happy birthday, Muhammad Nizami. Hope you have a wonderful... Wonderful birthday. Sorry, Mel did mention it, but then I forgot. Joe, how's it, Joe Emilio? Be sure to go and subscribe to Joe Emilio, by the way. He is a moderator. Yeah. He's a semi-funny guy. You know, like a semi? Sometimes great, sometimes not. I'm joking. He's great. Check out Joe Emilio. Or he will wear his stupid scarf. Yeah, that South African flag scarf. So he's either going to wear a Springbok jersey, something green and gold, or that South African scarf. I think he might be jet lagged, so you'll just probably put on that the Springbok jersey. Okay, he's not live yet. It's now officially 3 minutes past 8. I know that I'm one to talk, by the way. I'm always late too, but I'm not the president of this country. Julle kan fucking gelukkig wees vir daai een. Jurgens gave a 35 rand super chat saying, as die cricket in die finaal kom, denk jy hy gaan daar wees met dieselfde ondersteuning en gaan ons nog 'n vakansiedag kry? Jurgens, okay, let me not try and be negative, but I don't watch cricket for obvious reasons. Because the best 11 is not on the field. Secondly, I mean, we know, surely, that they're not going to make the final. Anyway, here's the president. Yes, well, okay. No, not yet. Something happened, yeah. I don't want to be negative. Like, I don't like killing, like, or being negative about sport, but I don't support the Proteas because of Cricket South Africa. And to be very honest, we all know what happens. Because during the group stages, hey, the best in the world. Anyway, yeah. Here we go. Sorry.
Our national rugby team, the Springboks, became the world champions of rugby for the fourth time since the advent of democracy in our country.
Ooh, that was
we
close.
Thus gained the bragging rights of being the only nation
Why is it not
to have won the Webb Ellis Trophy
not working.
Four times. As a nation, we should be overjoyed. As we celebrated and watched the progress of our team towards the championship, we marveled.
Oh shit, sorry.
At their resilience and determination to overcome some of the best teams in rugby in the world. At moments when their cause seemed lost and our hearts almost stopped,
like
they fought back and they emerged victorious to our great delight. This victory rightfully calls for a moment of national recognition and indeed celebration of our rugby players and their achievements, but also to celebrate the performance of the coaching team, all the assistants and the officials who contributed to this enormous victory. We should, as we celebrate the Springboks, also applaud our cricket team, who have been performing extremely well
that is a really
in the
shirt.
Cricket World Cup.
It looks like you need to still colour it in.
I spoke to the Proteas captain, Themba Bavuma.
The person gave up
and encouraged them to remain focused and told him that the entire nation supports and stands behind them. I also told him that I intend to travel to Mumbai in India to watch them play in the finals.
Oh, okay.
As we confront the many severe challenges in our country, we draw hope and encouragement from the determination and the performance of the Springboks and the Proteas as they have displayed their
okay,
prowess.
Okay, quickly, Cyril, who plays
the
number four for the Springboks?
And
quickly,
the performance
answer. Quickly.
Of the Proteas.
Who's the number four
the victory
Springbok?
Of Banyana Banyana in the Women's Africa Cup of Nations. And their progress to the knockout stages of the FIFA Women's World Cup. That also makes us proud. Our spirits were similarly lifted by the achievements of our national squad at the Special Olympics World Games in Berlin in June. They came to the Union Buildings.
All of them now.
We
back
recognized
to 1994.
Them and we applauded them. The determination and resilience of our sporting teams have given credence to Madiba's words that sports unites the nation.
You are no Madiba, my friend.
We have seen this in the celebrations that have been taking place across the country. We have seen how the victories that our Springboks have achieved through their various matches, the quarterfinals, the semifinals, and now the finals.
Thank you. That's how it works, guys. Didn't know.
In celebration and in great unity.
Get to the point.
In their achievements, our sportsmen and women
only he can make sport boring.
Have revealed much about the unity of the people of the country that they represent.
That has to suffer under you, you're
right. As a people, we have shown before what is possible when we are united.
Kiss a cunt,
when we are determined.
Kiss a cunt.
When we try hard and when we refuse to give up.
Mm.
Together, we overcame apartheid.
Hey,
and
he mentioned
centuries
it.
Centuries of conflict and gave birth
we
to
knew
a thriving
it.
Democracy.
We knew he was going to bring up apartheid.
Together, we confronted and overcame the deadliest pandemic in over a century. However, we continue to mourn those South Africans that we lost. We are indeed stronger together.
Thank you.
As we reflect on these great achievements on the sporting field, we also need to reflect on our economic recovery
oh.
and the further steps that we are taking to revive economic growth.
Why are we needing to revive it? You destroyed it.
As the latest census figures show, we have achieved great feats.
Registered to vote. That's going to be his message.
In human development since the beginning of democracy.
He's going to go the
Millions of South Africans have been raised out of poverty and now have housing and access to electricity, water, sanitation, and other basic needs.
60% youth unemployment rate.
Many of our people did not have
electricity for half the day.
Before democracy.
Well done, ANC.
Access to healthcare and education have been greatly expanded.
Okay, that's news.
Much more still needs to be done.
Yo, he's politicizing
more progress
for all it's worth.
The lives of our people.
He's making orange juice here.
Even
from
over the last 10 years, we've seen improvement, and we've been able to make significant strides.
Hasn't the unemployment rose over the last 10 years?
The percentage of households in formal dwellings rose from 78% in 2011 to 89% in 2022.
So you built 20 more houses.
This is evidence of concrete progress and should give us encouragement.
Why don't you give us the
numbers? The
challenges. Don't give us the percentages
of the present.
Because you can go from 0 to 100% if you build one house.
Since we embarked on the Economic Reconstruction and Recovery Plan, which outlined the actions that we would take to rebuild our economy and create jobs.
Are we speaking about the Springboks? Are you trying to campaign for the coming elections? What are you doing?
Accepted and socialized to many stakeholders in our country and was fully embraced by many. And it is underpinned by our national development.
I can't get over this
plan,
font. This SABC.
Which sets out a clear vision.
1991 font
we should
is
be going
just too much
as a
for
country.
Me.
The last 3 years have been extremely challenging.
Thanks to the ANC.
We're emerging from more than a decade of stagnant economic growth, compounded by the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic.
COVID wasn't 10 years.
We are working to reverse the legacy of the past era of corruption and mismanagement of our state-owned enterprises.
Oh, how many ministers have you
fired? Which has left us with a persistent energy crisis.
If you fired, how many people from the Zondo Commission have you arrested?
Ports and rail network.
None.
And we are contending with a range of global and domestic pressures, which
like
have set
supporting
us back
Russia, standing with Palestine,
on our
right?
Economic recovery.
Well done.
And yet, there are clear signs that our efforts are showing results. Electricity supply is improving,
but yet we have load shedding.
Jobs are being created
in the Western Cape.
Houses. Roads, bridges, and dams are under construction.
Where?
Law enforcement agencies are cracking down on criminal syndicates.
I've got, there's 80 vacancies in my police station where I'm the ward counselor. 80 vacancies.
These are reasons for hope.
They don't have more. They can't get more.
When the COVID-19 pandemic struck, we put in place
COVID-19 the new apartheid? Is that now the new excuse for the next 20 years?
That saved many lives. To deal with the negative economic effects of the pandemic, which resulted in the loss of more than 2 million jobs, we put in place an unprecedented stimulus package that lessened the damage to the economy and to the lives of many people.
It was COVID's fault.
Since then,
it's apart
in the midst
fault.
Of
it's
severe
fault.
Load shedding
it's
and increased
the
global
fault.
Volatility,
as the ANC
the economy has
claimed
continued
to be
to grow,
guilty for anything.
It slowly. The economy has shown a significant degree of resilience,
despite
and is
the
now
ANC.
Larger than it was before the pandemic.
Well, that happens
over the last
year
2 years.
It's supposed to happen.
The number of people with jobs has increased by 2 million.
Thank you, Western Cape.
Bringing the level of employment close to its pre-pandemic level. Remembering that
still 30-something percent,
more
right?
than 2 million jobs as a result of the pandemic. A key element of the reconstruction
when are you talking about the Springboks? Give us our public holiday and end
social protection and public employment. The special SRD grant, known as the 350 Rand grant,
your voting
which we introduced
buy-in
in 2020, grant. Has kept millions of people out of poverty.
Your vote buying grant.
And continues to provide much needed support for those who are unemployed.
And it still continues.
However little it is.
Okay, when are you stopping it though?
Presidential employment stimulus has created over 1.2 million opportunities since its establishment, representing the largest expansion of public employment in South Africa's history.
History?
Over 4 million young people have registered on the SA Youth online platform.
How many of them are getting jobs?
And more than 1 million of these have been able to access opportunities for learning and earning.
For how long?
Every one of those jobs,
just 1 or 2 days of work, is not employment.
Every person who no longer lives in poverty is a reason for hope. Another commitment we made in the Reconstruction and Recovery Plan was to fix South Africa's infrastructure through renewed investment.
Oh, I'm sure that's
and maintenance
going well.
And construction.
I mean, because no metro has got crumbling infrastructure. Several
significant infrastructure projects are now underway.
Where are these projects?
These projects are both contributing to greater economic activity and jobs.
Where?
And providing much needed infrastructure for the growth of our economy and the needs of our people. These infrastructure projects range from social housing, road construction, rural bridges, and dam constructions.
Don't swear at me.
The Passenger Rail Agency of South Africa, PRASA, has to date restored operations on 26 out of 40 commuter rail corridors. And getting our people
Are you gonna mention SAA
back to
too?
Trains lessens the expenditure that they've had to expend in paying for transportation.
Did the teleprompter stop now?
To continue with the restoration of our commuter rail corridors, 50 billion rand will be spent over the next 3 years to modernize our passenger rail network.
And how much of that will actually go
as part of our
on
infrastructure build?
And not in CADA's pockets.
We are undertaking significant water infrastructure projects. These include phase two of the Lesotho Highlands Water Project, the Umzimvubu Water Project,
bruh,
the Eastern Cape.
I thought we were here to get a holiday, and you are now
around
promoting the
country, the
ANC.
We
like,
are also
give us just this Springbok victory and give us our public holiday
water that
and
our
end
are
it. As a brief, I get me opgesigned for a speech,
areas,
nie. I get opgesigned for a public holiday. As a brief.
Pumping stations.
And if people agree with me,
are being
just
repaired,
like,
and pipes
give your thumbs
are being
up, please.
To get water to underserviced areas. I was
Donkey.
Fortunate
okay,
to go
great.
To
well done. Metri imaginary Wakanda projects.
So
well done. You've
exactly
phenomenal job, Cyril. Just give me my holiday, please.
Cleaning up the sewage.
Yeah, sewage. That's everywhere in the streets.
The water
you're right.
Treatment areas.
Give me my holiday.
We're making progress towards ending load
You're
shedding.
Making no progress. Stop talking cock.
Our greatest priority
You just spoke
has
about sewage and you're talking about progress.
And frequency of load shedding to achieve energy security.
We still have load shedding.
Over the last
You
few
didn't
months,
even give us 24 hours to celebrate.
Measurable
we got load shedding like
the severity of
8 hours
shedding.
After the final.
The energy action plan that I announced in July
There's no
last
action
year,
plan. It's just no energy.
Showing positive results, giving us greater confidence that we will bring load shedding to an end.
By 2040.
Regulatory reforms we have initiated have enabled a massive increase in private investment in electricity generation.
It's always private investment.
With over 12,000
hey,
megawatts
hey.
Of confirmed projects
settle.
In development. Following the introduction
settle.
Of tax incentives.
Hey, psst.
And financing mechanisms, the amount of installed rooftop solar has more than doubled to over 4,500 megawatts in the last year.
Holiday.
The steady progress we are making in resolving the energy crisis is a reason for hope. We are making progress in restoring our logistics system to bring it to world-class standards once again, so that we can export South African goods to global markets. The National Logistics Crisis Committee is overseeing a range of interventions to stabilize and improve the performance of the logistics system in the short term, in addition to ongoing reform to improve its efficiency and competitiveness in the long term. The Transnet Board has developed a turnaround plan which aims to increase volume.
Did somebody give him the wrong speech here?
On our network. Progress is also being made with the introduction of private sector participation.
We signed up for the public holiday
at our ports.
Imagine he doesn't give us a public holiday.
I want to make it clear.
Imagine we had to sit here and listen to this and he doesn't even give us a public holiday.
Electricity infrastructure are strategic national assets.
Yeah, people are going to riot in public ownership. Die mense gaan hulle kak verloor.
Introducing competition
as in for a public holiday
in electricity.
We didn't sign up to come and listen to false pretense
to reduce prices in the
we
long
thought
term.
We're getting a public holiday
just
no preekie man.
Of competition.
It's like wanneer hy dominee sê hey in conclusion en ons het nog 30 minute preek. Nee.
And enormous benefit.
Nee, Cyril. Nee.
We are also making progress in tackling crime and corruption. The South African Police Service has established 20 economic infrastructure task teams throughout the country to protect critical infrastructure
and
tackle the construction mafia.
It's actually good because he's just pissing off more people. Like the ANC mining, really does not have a
cash
clue,
in transit.
Okay? The Springboks win the World Cup on
cable
Saturday,
theft, drugs,
and this man is here
crimes,
talking about how they're going to end corruption,
the number
but
of
nobody has been arrested.
And women
nobody has been arrested from Parliament, from the Zondo Commission report. Nobody's been arrested.
Criminality.
Give us all
more and more of these policemen and women who are being trained.
Yeah, where are they? Because in my ward, we need 80. There's 80 vacancies. 80.
I've also extended the employment of 880 members of the South African National Defence Force
Rama,
to support the police
in
combating
dag,
criminal
asubleef,
activity, particularly activity that targets
ek het nie opgesigned
economic
vir die speech nie.
Infrastructure.
Just give me my holiday.
The police have arrested several people for extortion at construction sites.
Several!
Over 3,000 arrests for illegal mining.
Well done.
Through the intensive efforts of our law enforcement agencies.
Well done,
dozens of
Ele.
Illegal
well done.
Mines.
Phenomenal job.
Unregulated Ele. Coal yards.
We still have 70 murders a day, but well done on that. Several arrests for
have been shut
corruption
down
or whatever.
The economic infrastructure task teams have confiscated significant quantities of copper cable,
confiscated
rail tracks, coal, Narra and other metals.
Confiscated.
Every
I've
arrest made
and
every length of cable recovered is a reason for hope.
Confiscated.
We are making progress in the fight against corruption as well, including bringing those responsible for state capture to justice. Over the last 4 years, the NPA Investigating Directorate has taken 34 state capture corruption cases
I don't even
to court
think he knows
involving
what he's doing.
205 accused persons.
They put
persons
him in that chair and just put the teleprompter
freezing
on.
Orders of 14
he's
billion
the wrong
rand
Cyril,
have now
you're
been granted
the wrong speech.
To the asset
this speech
forfeiture
is for next week.
For state capture
the wrong
related
speech,
cases.
Cyril, wrong
around
speech.
5.4 billion
can somebody tell him that this is not
the,
to the it's not opening of
as
parliament.
As recommended by the State Capture
Please,
Commission.
Please, help him.
We are putting in place laws.
Confiscate his
institutions
speech. Please.
And practices that reduce the potential for corruption of any sort and on any scale.
Confiscate his speech.
We are continuing
speech,
to build meaningful compacts with key stakeholders in a number of areas.
If you want Cyril to stop speaking, to smash that like button right now, please.
Enhancing
and also don't forget to subscribe.
We have established a partnership with business to work together in four critical areas.
Ek het geweet hy gaan kak praat. Ek het nie geweet hy gaan net kak praat
nie. In crime and corruption as well. We continue to collaborate with organized labor.
So I'm warning
and civil society to ensure a whole of society approach to addressing the most important challenges of our country.
If you falsely did this without giving people a public holiday, julle gaan kak.
I had a wonderful meeting with all our labor federations just last week.
This is false advertising.
Hours.
False
and
advertising.
All of us agreed that it was the most meaningful meeting from which will emerge.
By the way, does any of the 3,221 people here actually care anything about what he's saying right now? In the comments, if you actually care of what he's talking about, say yes. If you don't care what he's talking about right now, say no.
Despite the progress we are making, poverty, inequality, and unemployment remain high.
Because of the ANC.
We continue to face domestic and global pressures, and our economy is growing too slowly for us to overcome the challenges facing
Why is it not growing?
Load shedding has constrained economic growth.
Who caused it?
The underperformance of the ports and rail network.
Who caused it?
It's affecting our ability to get exports to market.
Who caused it?
Government spending has exceeded the revenue that we collect.
Who caused it?
The 2008 global financial crisis.
Oh, so it's a 2008 financial. It's not the ANC.
Increase in economic growth.
Oh, so that's the fault, not
the
ANC.
Minister of Finance has noted, for every rand that government collects in revenue,
how much is stolen?
18 cents go towards servicing our national debt.
The rest is stolen.
This means that we are now paying more in interest on our national debt than we are budgeting for the police force.
This is not the finance speech.
Ultimately,
so confiscate the speech.
And inclusive growth is the only solution to unemployment, poverty, and inequality.
What never has a president missed an opportunity like
the
this.
Challenges that we face.
You know, it's bad when you say I miss Jacob Zuma.
Underspending. Growth is also necessary for the sustainability
today,
of our public finances.
For the next 705 days, we have public holiday.
We are making.
Because I am Jacob Zuma.
Accelerate the implementation of the economic reforms that we have embarked upon. Many of these reforms were identified in our ERRP, and many more will
this
be.
This man's not going to give us a public holiday, is he?
To address the weaknesses
in many of our municipalities,
we are undertaking interventions in local government. As national government, we are driving a number of interventions to support
a
rapid turnaround in local government services.
It's when somebody gives you a pamphlet that says you can win a free or you'll get a free weekend away.
These interventions are accelerating
and then you go there,
delivery
and then you have to pay for it. This is what it is. The pamphlet
while
says
addressing the immediate problems,
attend and get a free holiday, and when you get there, then it's
and the professionalization.
Only one day is free after you buy 7 days of a holiday. This is it. This is it. He's doing this to us.
The achievement of sustained and inclusive growth requires a stable macroeconomic environment.
I can't believe
it. A sustainable fiscal trajectory is a precondition for growth. We therefore remain absolutely committed to stabilizing our levels of debt and adopting a responsible
he is so boring.
Policy.
He actually wore the right shirt because people are literally watching this on their tablets, painting
plans to achieve
the
this
colors in on his t-shirt.
In the
on his shirt,
budget
he's worn the perfect shirt for the speech because
spending
people are
on
there
health, education,
on their tablets,
and other
like
essential services
blue, green,
will be protected
red,
as far as possible.
Pink, green,
as
and
we
gold.
Move to target spending on programs.
He's got the perfect shirt.
Working for the
it's
poor.
Like that game you get on we the iPad that you have to put in your own colors. He's wearing that T-shirt.
Including the SRD grant as well as our public employment programs are vital in supporting those who are vulnerable.
If this is the biggest these missed opportunity for Cyril Ramaphosa and the ANC, poverty, smash that like button right
have
now.
Have enabled recipients to search
paint
for
by
jobs
numbers. He's wearing a paint by numbers shirt
to support their livelihoods.
Because his speech is so boring,
the Minister
people
of Finance
are literally colouring
in. Provide more details of these and other spending priorities when he presents the medium-term.
Thanks for the super chat, Liesl Species, Akful Yammer for Sam K.
Akful
Yammer for Nimadni.
The initiatives we
go
are
Booker
going to be embarking upon.
Thank you, Liesl.
To
I
restructure
do bad for him,
the government as well to reduce expenditure.
Yeah, pause, Cyril.
Today marks the start of the 2023 National Senior Certificate exams for matriculants. And this affects almost 1 million learners.
My matric was 22 years ago geskryf.
Our learners.
Worry nie oor matriekie. Gee my my holiday. Ek soek my pause, Cyril.
Education and the investment that we have made as
ek soek
a nation.
My pause.
In their education. We wish them the very best, confident that they will make the country proud once again. There are many reasons for hope. We have made significant progress in reforming our economy to make it more inclusive and to achieve higher rate of growth. As we implement our reforms, yes, we will be preparing our economy for even greater growth. We are on track to resolve the most important constraints on economic growth by stabilizing our energy supply and fixing our logistics network. The reforms underway will propel economic growth in South Africa in the years to come, resulting in a stable supply of electricity, a working railway,
by when?
And more jobs for all South Africans.
On
our way to rebuilding our economy, there are a number of strengths that stand us in good stead.
Like what?
We have a strong and sophisticated financial sector, a strong and effective civil society, a functional democracy, an independent judiciary, a stable macroeconomic framework underpinned by a capable national treasury, and an independent reserve bank.
That you want
we
to nationalize.
We have collectively embarked on a journey of economic reform, which will set our country on a path to higher growth and more jobs. The concerted efforts of all South Africans are starting to show results in many areas. If we take a short-term view of our current challenges, we may not see the transformation that is underway or the benefits
he's truly not going to give us a public holiday
for our country.
This was a scam.
I'm confident
Cyril
that through
us.
The actions we are taking now, we will overcome the challenges we face and build a society that works for all of its people.
Sure.
We have much more to do, but like
this
the Springboks, we have the determination and commitment to overcome any challenge. Our Victoria Springboks will return home tomorrow.
Oh, finally.
We will
He's
welcome
back on
them
track,
with
guys.
Great joy and jubilation.
Somebody
they
confiscated this
they
speech.
They will conduct a victory tour around the country, and I will receive them at the Union Buildings later this week.
Sorry
I want
them.
Us to now rally behind the Proteas.
So are we getting that holiday?
In the same way as we have given our support to the Springboks.
Can I suppose
I want us all to embark on a period of celebration, culminating in a celebratory holiday.
Yes!
After our matriculants
it was worth
have
it.
Finished their exams and the Proteas have done the country proud.
No, one year.
Cricket World Cup. I know that many of us want us to have a public holiday now to
I
celebrate.
I wanted Poser, no!
But we should all agree that we should give our matriculants time to focus
my
on their exams and celebrate with them afterwards.
Nee.
Otherwise, it will disrupt their ability to focus on their most important
Just had to go the funny route with the stream.
And matriculation exams, and this affects close on to a million.
Jy gaan op ons pause die 25ste Desember gee.
In celebration of the Springboks' momentous achievement and the achievements of all our other sportsmen and women, and as a tribute to the resolve of our united nation, I'm declaring Friday the 15th of December 2023 as a public holiday.
Nice.
We declare this to be a day of hope, a day of celebration, and unity.
What's the day called?
Our sportsmen and women,
anti-ANC day,
have shown us what is possible. We will succeed, and we will ensure that we leave no one behind.
Oh, okay.
Gosi sikeleli Africa. Gosi katekisa Africa. Hot sien said Africa.
Yeah.
Jimu va patuchedze Africa
chibele. Hierdie man is so desperate, hy gooi sommer Afrikaans vir hy wout.
I thank you.
Ja nee, hy gooi sommer die Afrikaans vir hy wout. Bliksem. Okay, so that was very painful. That was, I mean, we literally went, you know, we went apartheid, confiscated, economic transformation, the ANC is not guilty to blame anything, it's colonialism, it's Jan van Riebeeck, it's apartheid, it's Hy bliksem wat 17 van 'n vyfstraat bly. It's everybody's fault except the ANC's fault. But hey, they have a plan. They're going to turn all of this around. They're going to end load shedding. They're going to, our economy is going to grow by 600%. Rail is coming back. Even though if the trains had to get on there now, they would literally like be one of those hovering trains because there's no train tracks. Apparently, there's no potholes. Dams are coming. Fuck, it klink lekker. But anyway, we got a public holiday, the 15th of December. What the president should have done is literally, my fellow South Africans, well done to the Springboks. The public holiday is on the 15th of December. If he did that, that would have been great. Instead, we had to get a lecture on how the ANC has achieved so much and is doing so much. Oh, ignore the load shedding. Ignore the unemployment rate. Ignore the state of this country. Don't look at that. No, no, I'm not. Hey, here. Kijk hier. Kijk hier zo. Moet niet daar kijken. Kijk hier. Focus here. Don't look at that. Look here. Right over here. Sorry. I had to like make it humorous because it's just so depressing. It's so, so depressing. Okay. Thank you, Leon, for the super chat saying we cannot enjoy a week of Springbok victory. Exactly. Kevin Snelter, thank you for the 14 rand saying Rassi for president. I agree. Gideon van der Merwe, well, Rassi is a dispatcher. So you must know if Rassi becomes the president of this country, goed gaan skit, papa. Goed gaan skit. Gideon says this is what AI generated Cyril looks like. I fully agree. I still think he's in the air. I don't think that was him doing that speech. Emil Halaby gave a 35 rand super chat. Thank you very much, Emil. What an absolute superstar on my ward. Saying Sam Kane's a gat. A wen is a wen. Exactly, Emil. Thank you for the super chat and thanks for the great stuff that you do in Ward 2. It's greatly appreciated. Leanne gave a 35 rand super chat saying there are already a ton of dams on our roads. We don't need more. Exactly. All right. Let me just check here if I can give maybe some stream love. Yes, I can give some stream love. So I am not going to be a Cyril. What I will ask you, okay, I'm not going to be a Cyril in the sense of keeping you here without you having to be here. Let me give a shout out to a company that's doing the most. This, if you want to get the real Cyril speech, check out Steal and Plunder. Check it out. It's a board game. Just Google it. If you don't even need the link. Just Google Steal and Plunder board game. Master the art of corruption. Your way to the top of the Mzansi shadow economy. It's a board game. It says there, Under Corruption, first edition. Be sure to check it out. There is the, how you play this game. Very, very cool. That is that money that I offered Cyril that he wasn't taking. And then obviously, if you want some copper, I know a guy. It's all part of the game. So be sure to check it out. Steal and Plunder. I'm not getting paid for this. I just want to say thanks to the guys for coming up with a very unique South African game. I love these type of things. Debbie Moray did put the link in the description there, and same with Gavin. Thank you for that. Mel Bell gave a 10 euro super chat. Thank you for that super sticker. Bertus Hills gave a 7 rand super chat. Thank you very much for that. It's greatly appreciated. So what I'm going to do is, I want to see how committed you guys are. So there's another YouTuber that is an American that does phenomenal work to report on what's happening in South Africa. His name is Chris Wyatt. The reason I'm talking as if you are supposed to know who he is because, or like you don't know who he is because a lot of you don't actually watch my channel religiously. So what's going to happen is I've added his link so that when I end the stream, it will switch over automatically to his stream. So when you get there, I don't want you to tag me. I just want you to say, Gouws sent me, right? I want to see how many of the 1,700 people that's here will listen to, will move over and continue to watch there. Chris is a very knowledgeable American, and I know that's an oxymoron for most people, but Chris is a very knowledgeable person on South Africa and specifically on rugby. He is a retired colonel from the United States military that served close to 3 decades in Africa. So if you don't know who he is, trust me, you're going to find a gem, and he's going to probably talk about the speech behind Cyril more articulate than what I ever could, because he is very knowledgeable on the economy, South Africa, and various other things. So I'm going to end it now, and I would like to see most of you go over there and just listen to him for 5 minutes. And if you don't find it interesting, then leave. But if you find it interesting, subscribe to Chris, because he is a phenomenal individual. He loves South Africa, and he's very passionate about rugby. So Teresa, thank you for the 350 rand super chat. Really appreciate that. Saying, jy's loshande een van my gunsteling controversiële figure in Suid-Afrika. Why am I controversial? Hoekom is that controversial? I'm just saying it the way it is. I'm saying what most people are thinking but are too scared to say. So thank you very much for the 350 rand. I really do appreciate it. I haven't seen a purple or a pink in a very long time. Thank you very much for that. And I will just continue being me. And if that is controversial, then so be it. But with that being said, thank you for all for tuning in. Smash the like button on your way out. And please just stay tuned. After this, you'll be redirected. Tell Chris Gouws sent me. And be sure to subscribe to him. Be sure to smash the like button on his channel as well. Phenomenal, phenomenal YouTube content creator. I can guarantee you that you'll love what he has to say. All right, that's it from my side. Thank you so much for tuning in. Have a lovely rest of your Monday. And hey, public holiday on the 15th. Settle that phone's pose. Papa, yeah.